Good morning, children.
Morning.
So in the last class, we discussed about Pythagoras theorem, isn't it? We are solving problems based on Pythagoras theorem. Okay. And in the last class, we discussed one important question, proving the in an equilateral triangle, we proved 9AD square is equal to 7AB square, isn't it? 9AD square is equal to 7AB square. Once again, I'll repeat it. We have already copied it. Follow this. Okay, check that one. Is it clear? It's an important one. Okay, that's why I'm repeating it. Read the question, the last question that we discussed in the class. What is the question? Can you read the question? In an equilateral triangle ABC, isn't it? It is given. Triangle ABC is equilateral. In triangle ABC is an equilateral triangle. No need to copy it. Already you have copied it. I'm explaining it once again because it's an important one. Okay. ABC is an equilateral triangle and D is a point such that BD is equal to 1/3 BC. This is given. Okay. What do you have to prove? We have to prove 9AD square is equal to 9AD square is equal to 7AB square. This is what we have to prove. So it is given triangle ABC is an equilateral triangle. So equilateral triangle means we get all the sides as equal. AB is equal to BC is equal to AC. We get all the three sides as equal. So we draw one equilateral triangle. So let ABC be the equilateral triangle. In order to use Pythagoras theorem, we need one altitude. So for that, we do one construction here. What is the construction? We draw AE perpendicular to BC. Draw AE perpendicular to BC. It is given as an equilateral triangle. So in an equilateral triangle, altitude will be same as median. It will coincide. Isn't it? So we get BE is equal to EC is equal to half of BC. BE is equal to EC is equal to half of BC. We name this as equation 2. This is equation 1. All the three sides are equal. This is equation 1. Already it is given BD is 1/3 BC. Okay, so we construct like this. Now BD is given. What is BD? 1/3 of BC. And we know that 1/3 is smaller. So we draw the point D. So we don't bother about this triangle. We consider only these two triangles, ABE and ADE. So first we consider the big triangle. In triangle ABE, by using Pythagoras theorem, what you will get? By using triangle ABE, if you use Pythagoras theorem, we get AB square is equal to AE square plus BE square. AE square plus BE square. We name this as equation 3. Now take the next triangle ADE. In triangle ADE, again using Pythagoras theorem, we get AD square is equal to AE square plus DE square. Okay, so therefore, what will be AE square? AE square will be AD square minus DE square. We find out what is AE square. Now substitute this in equation 1. You substitute this in, not 1, in third equation you substitute. When you substitute this in equation 3, we get AB square is equal to AE. Instead of AE, we write AD square minus DE square plus BE square. Is it okay? We substitute for AE. Okay. So now this is the same as AD square minus, what is DE? How we wrote this DE? Just go through the notes that we wrote that day. Okay. I'm explaining it once again. No need to copy it now. Okay. We have copied this already. Now, how will you write DE? We can write DE as If you want this BE, how will you write the E? It is BE minus BD the whole square. BE minus BD the whole square plus BE square. So that is same as AD square minus. What about BE? Look at BE. BE is half of BC, isn't it? Half of BC. And what about BD? It is given. It is given BD as 1 by 3 BC plus BE square. BE, we can write this as BE by 2 the whole square. BE is half of BC. That is same as AD square minus, now take the LCM here, 6. LCM is 6. So we multiply 3 here. 3 BC minus 2 BC the whole square plus BC square by 4. That is AD square minus, what is 2 BC minus 3 BC minus 2 BC? 3 BC minus 2 BC is, you'll get BC, isn't it? BC by 6 the whole square plus BC squared by 4. Next step, we square this. Next step, we square this. When we square this, we get AD square minus BC square by 36 plus BC square by 4. Now for these two terms, you take the common LCM as 36. Here it is into 9, into 9. We get BC square plus 9BC square. Now from 9BC square, if 1BC square is removed, means we get 8BC square by 36. 8 and 36 we can cancel by 4. We get AD square plus 2BC square by 9. But what we know, AB is equal to BC is equal to AC. All the three sides are equal. All the three sides are equal. So instead of BC, we can replace it with AC. So we get, okay, so what we will get here, we get AB square is equal to AD square plus 2 into, instead of BC, we can write this as AB square by 9. Now take this AB square to one side. AB square minus 2AB square by 9 is equal to AD square. You take the LCM, so we get 9AB square minus 2AB square by 9 is equal to AD square. So therefore we get 7AB square by 9 is equal to AD square. So when you cross multiply, we get 7AB square is equal to 9AD square. So we have proved the results. Is it okay? That day we proved this. Once again, I explained this one because this is an important one. Okay. Is it okay, children? Okay. I hope you all copied this.
Yes, ma'am.
Prajod, is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
The day before yesterday, I have sent 10 MCQ questions. Ah, yes.
Ma'am, will you show that last part one more time?
Yes. I have sent 10 questions in AP. Did you try that AP? Only few of them solved it and they have asked the doubts. What about the others? Have solved it? If you have solved it, you can just send a message. I'll send the answer. Those who give a message, I have passed, send the answers to check it. Okay. You have that MCQ sheet sent by Sal. You can take the printout and you can try to solve it. 10 questions within 10 minutes, 12 questions within 12 minutes. Like that, you try to solve it. Once I send the answer, you can check it. How many questions are correct? How many marks you are getting? Is it okay, Rifa?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, children. Now, let's do the next other question. Write this question. Write this. I think you copied this question that I have sent. I asked you to copy this question. Look at this question. what is given? In the given figure, O is the point in the interior of the triangle ABC. In the given figure, O is the point in the interior of the triangle ABC. OD is perpendicular to BC. OE is perpendicular to AC. OF is perpendicular to AB. First one, what you have to prove? We have to prove OA square plus OB square plus OC square minus OD square minus OE square minus OF square is equal to AF square plus BD square plus CE square. This is the first result we want to prove. We have to prove OA square plus OB square plus OC square minus OD square minus OE square minus OF square is equal to AF square plus BD square plus CE square. So for proving this result, okay, so look at this. First, you'll look at the sides. Which are the sides we want? Okay, after drawing this figure, look at the result. Which are the sides you want here? We want the side OA, OB, OC. Then we want OD. OD is this one. OE, OF equal to AF square, BD square and CE square. Okay, and CE square. So look at here. So which are the triangles you are getting here? When you mark these points in the figure, which are the triangles you are getting here? Which triangles and all are there? Fully covered triangles. When you mark all the sides, which are the triangles you will get from the figure? Can you identify the smaller triangles which are fully colored? Which are the triangles you will get? It is? Is it OFC? Is it OFC fully colored? This part. Okay, this triangle is fully shaded. Then this part is fully shaded and this one is fully shaded. Is that no? These are the three triangles. So, and these three triangles are right triangles. These three triangles are right triangles. So using Pythagoras theorem, we can use Pythagoras theorem in all these triangles, in all these three triangles. So in triangle OAF, if you use Pythagoras theorem, we get OA square is equal to OF square plus AF square. Hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus altitude square. Now look at the result. In the result, we want OA square minus OF. So I'm taking OF to other side. OA square minus OF square is equal to AF square. This is equation one. This is equation one. Listen, children, once again, I repeat, in the question, it is given O is the point interior of the triangle. OD is perpendicular to BC. OE is perpendicular to AC and OF is perpendicular to AB. We have to prove the first part. In order to prove the first part, what we do here, we color those sides. What is given in the question? You mark it in the figure. When we mark it in the figure, we get three right triangles, three smaller right triangles we get. So we can take the first right angle triangle in triangle OAF. OA is the hypotenuse. So we get OA square is equal to OF square plus AF square. In the, yes? Yes, children, is it okay? Arjun? And in the results, we have OA square minus OF square. Is it okay, Arjun? Okay, so name this as equation one. Now take the next right angle triangle. Which is the next right angle triangle? BOD. If you use Pythagoras theorem, what you will get? In triangle BOD, which is the hypotenuse, Rose? Which is the hypotenuse? OB. So we, yes, OB square is equal to OD square plus BD square. Again, if you take OD to other side, we get OB square minus OD square is equal to B BD square. This is the second equation. Now take the last next triangle in triangle COE. In triangle COE, hypotenuse is OC. So Vishnupriya, apply Pythagoras theorem and give the result in triangle OEC.
OC square is equal to OE square plus EC square.
Okay, therefore what you will get?
OC square minus OE square is equal to EC
square. Okay. So look at the result, children. In the results, we want to prove. Okay, in the results, we have all the sides with O, starting with O on one side, and the other things in the other side. Okay, here we use in all the three cases we use Pythagoras theorem. By using Pythagoras theorem only we get this result. So by Pythagoras theorem only we get all these results. Now add these three equations. You add 1 + 2 + 3. Add all the equations 1 + 2 + 3. When you add all these equations, what you will get? When we add all these equations, OA square plus OB square, I'm adding all the LHS, minus OF square minus OD square minus OE square is equal to AF square plus BD square plus CE square. Whether we have proved the result first one, hence first one is proved. Whether we have proved the first result. And Mary, is it okay? Is it okay, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, can I rejoin?
Who is asking this one?
Ma'am, Hainsty.
Okay, Hainsty. Melvin, is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Rifa? Here?
Ma'am, will you explain one more time from the equation?
From the equations. Okay, from the equations, what we do here, we use Pythagoras theorem. Is it okay? We use Pythagoras theorem. And look in the results we want to prove. In the results, we want all the sides starting with O on one side and the other terms on the other side. So we have OA square is OF square plus AF square. So we take plus OF to other side. Plus OF square on taking other side, we get OA square minus OF square is AF square. Similarly, you take the next triangle. In the next triangle, by Pythagoras theorem, OB square is equal to OD square plus BD square. So OB square minus OD square is BD square. Similarly, we get the third equations. Now we add all these three equations. When we add only the LHS and we add the RHS. Okay, when you add this, we write all the positive terms in the first. OA square plus OB square plus OC square. Then I write all the negative terms. OF square minus OD square minus OE square is equal to AF square plus BD square plus CE square. Hence, we get the first results. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
So complete this one. Yes, the first part, is it over, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now look at the second results. Look at the results that we want to prove in the second results. Okay, so hope you all copied this one. Is it okay? You all copied that first part, Savio?
No, ma'am. Then it's all about.
Write it fast. Okay. Whether you have copied that questions which I have sent? Copied that questions, children? Johan? Johan is there? Did you copy those questions?
Ma'am.
Yes.
I have some problems. Can it one of my video?
Okay. Okay. Okay, children. Now look at the next result. Okay. Now look at the next result. So in the second result, what do you have to prove? Look at the second result. Okay. In second one, what do you have to prove? Look at the second part. Adidev, read the results. Second one, what do you have to prove?
AF square plus BD square is equal to CE square is equal to, no, AF plus, square plus BD square plus CE square equal to AE square plus CD square plus BF square.
AE square plus CD square plus BF square. Okay, this is what we have to prove. Okay, so you look at the sides BF. AF square plus BD square plus CE square is equal to AE square. Okay. AE means, look at this. I shade this side. AE. And CD. CD means this one. And what is the next one we want? BF. So this means, that means we are going to take the triangles which are not shaded in the first case. We are going to consider those triangles which are not shaded in the first case. So that means you take the first triangle AOE. In triangle AOE, using Pythagoras theorem, we get OA square is equal to OE square plus AE square. You select those triangles which are not selected for proving the first result. Okay, so those triangles are, I'm shading it in red color. OAE, OBF, and OCD. So if you take the triangle AOE, OA square, here it is 90 degree. So the side opposite to it, hypotenuse will be OA. OA square is equal to OE square plus AE square. So we get OA square minus OE square is equal to AE square. Name this as equation 4. Again, take the next triangle. In triangle BOD, if you apply Pythagoras theorem, we get OB square is equal to OD square plus BD square. OB square is equal to OD square plus BD square. So from here, we get OB square minus OD square is equal to.
First one, is it in a angle AOE, AOE or AB?
AOE.
Ma'am, but BOD we took right last one.
Sorry, BOF, isn't it? We last, okay, red triangles only we have to consider. Okay, BOD we took, okay. So in triangle BOF, thank you. Okay, we take only those triangles which are shaded in red. In triangle BOF, so we get OB square. OB square is equal to, OB square, hypotenuse square is equal to BF square plus OF square, isn't it? So from here, OB square minus OF square is equal to BF square. That is equation 5. Again, the next one, which is not okay, which is not taken earlier. That means only these three triangles we consider. In triangle OCD, you consider the triangle OCD. So we get OC square is equal to OD square plus CD square. So we get OC square minus OD square is equal to CD square. This is equation 6. Now add these three equations, 4 plus 5 plus 6. When we add these three equations, we get OA square plus OB square plus OC square minus OE square minus OF square minus OD square is equal to OE, OF, OD is equal to AE square plus BF square plus CD square. Name this as equation 7. Look at the results we want to prove. Is this the result we want to prove? Is this the result we want to prove?
No, ma'am.
But how we can prove this? Very good. From the first one, isn't it? So from the first one, what you can do? This one we can replace with AF square
plus BD square.
AF square plus BD square plus
CD square
is equal to AE square plus BF square plus CD square. Hence we have proved the results. Okay, this is an easy question. We use only the Pythagoras theorem. Arrangement of triangles only we need. We have to select only those triangles according to the results. According to the results, we select those triangles. Is it clear, Vishnu Vivi? Vishnu?
Ma'am,
Vishnu?
Question yes? Plus 5 plus 6. No. After that, what you have written, will you read one more time?
OA square, we add those equations. We add those equations. OA square plus OB square plus OC square minus OE minus OF minus OD is equal to AE square plus BF square plus CD square. We add the LHS and we add the RHS. But if you look in the LHS from the first one, LHS we can replace it with AF square plus BD square plus CE square. That is from the Roman letter 1, from the first result. From the first result, you can replace it. So hence, we get the second result. Is it okay?
Ma'am, that one you have underlined. Will you read it?
OA square plus OB square plus OC square minus OE square minus OF square minus OD square. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
You can't see the board? What happened?
No, ma'am. That
can you saw the side?
First part you copied or not? First one you did that one, isn't it, Savio?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Mammy, first, what can you show the adding side? Right.
Wait. Second part, is it over, children?
Yes.
1 minute.
See, prepare well for the MCQ test paper. Portions I have sent. Three chapters are there. Quadratic, triangles. Triangles, full post, full chapter. And the AP. Is it over? Okay, Haynes, Steve.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, hence. Okay, children. Is it okay, Surya? Surya, is it okay?
Ma'am, can I show the board again? I lost connection in between.
Which one? This is the second part.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, can I explain the last part?
So we add these three equations. When we add these three equations, LHS we add, RHS we add. So when we add the LHS, we get OA square plus OB square plus OC square minus OE minus OF minus OD. We add the LHS and we add the RHS. Okay, when you add this LHS, if you look at the LHS, it is same as the first result. In the first result, you compare it with the first result. From the first result, this one we can be replaced with AF square plus BD square plus CE square. First one, we replace it from the first result, LHS. RHS is the same. Therefore, these two are equal.
Over, ma'am.
Okay. Now write this question, children. I think you wrote this question. One of you read this question. Yes, Savio, read the question, Savio.
Yes, ma'am. A ladder 10 meter long reaches a window 8 meter above the ground in the distance of the foot of the ladder from base of the wall.
Okay, find the distance of the foot of the ladder from the base of the wall. Listen, children, these are all will be asked for one mark question. You can expect such type of questions. These are application questions. So look at here. Okay, a ladder 10 meter long reaches a wall. So ladder, it reaches the wall. So wall means it will be vertical, isn't it? Let us take the wall, AB be the wall, and the ladder is kept leaning against it, BC, which is 10 meter. And the ladder, okay, a ladder 10 meter long reaches a window 8 meter above the ground. Find the distance of the foot of the ladder. We want to find the distance. We want to find the distance AC. Can you do this one? Can you solve this? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
How will you solve this?
Pythagoras theorem.
Pythagoras theorem. Okay. So start doing along with me. I'll not be giving extra time for copying. Start doing. Write down. Let AB be the wall and BC be the ladder. Let AB be the wall and AC BC be the ladder. Therefore, in triangle ABC. Therefore, in triangle ABC, if you use Pythagoras theorem, BC square is equal to AB square plus AC square. Within bracket, you write Pythagoras. Then apply the values. So 10 square is equal to 8 square plus AC square. For AC square is?
How did we understand it is 90 degree?
How the wall will be kept? Will it be vertical or not with the ground level?
Yes, ma'am.
So it is 90 degree. Vertical means it will be always 90 degree. Okay, wall will be always perpendicular to the ground. Okay, instead of wall, sometimes they will give the pole. Pole, okay, electric pole and all means it will be standing vertical. A person is standing means that is also vertical. Vertical lines means always they make 90 degree with the ground. Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
So AC square is 36. Therefore, what is AC?
Six.
6 meters. AC is 6 meters. Okay, so this is application. This type of questions you will get for one mark question. It will be asked for one mark. Applications. Okay. Meghna, is it clear, Meghna?
Ma'am, will you show the screen?
Meghna?
Yes, ma'am.
Badra, is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now let us move on to the next question.
Ma'am, what is it?
Yes. The next question.
That is answer.
Yes, children. Yes, Melvin.
That question finish.
What is asked in the question? What is asked in that question? We want to find the distance between the what is asked? Read the question. What is distance. Asked?
Find the distance of the foot of the ladder from base of the wall.
So which is the foot of the ladder then? Okay, listen children. This is the foot of the ladder, isn't it? This is the foot. Okay, this is the wall. This is the top. So what is the distance here? AC, isn't it? So you can, although we write AC, finally you can conclude it. Finally, you should conclude it mentioning that therefore the distance is 6 meters. The distance is 6 meters. Okay. Now look at the next question, children. Look at the next one. This is again an important question. Okay. The perpendicular from A on the side BC of triangle ABC intersects BC at D. So you are given a triangle ABC. You are given a triangle ABC. The perpendicular from A intersects C at the point D. And okay, so it is given. What is given here? AD is perpendicular to BC. And one more condition is given. DB is equal to 3CD. DB is equal to 3CD. We have to prove 2AB square is equal to 2AC square plus BC square. We have to prove 2AB square is equal to 2AC square plus BC square. So here one altitude is given, one perpendicular line is given, isn't it? How many right triangles are here? Nirubama, how many right triangles are here? Children, I find most of you are copying the question now. Why don't you copy it earlier? Have your hands, Steve? Amina? Others, video are off, so I can't see that one. Why? You didn't copy that question earlier? Why? Okay, listen, children. Okay. The perpendicular from A is drawn to the base BC. Okay, to intersect BC at a point D such that BD is equal to 3CD. We have to prove 2AB square is equal to 2AC square plus BC square. Okay, Nirubama, tell me how many right triangles are here?
Two.
Okay, so which are the two right triangles?
ADC and AD.
Okay, so you consider the first triangle, children. We consider the first triangle ABD. By using Pythagoras theorem, what you will get? By Pythagoras theorem, Arjun, tell me what you will get here.
AB square is equal to AD square plus BD square.
AD square plus BD square. I name this as equation one. Now take the next right angle triangle. Fia, which is the next right angle triangle? Fia?
ADC.
Yes, in triangle ADC by Pythagoras theorem. Okay, it is a right angle triangle. It's being a right angle triangle, we can use Pythagoras theorem. So by using Pythagoras theorem, we get AC square is equal to AD square plus BC square. Now look at the results. In the results, we want 2AB square is equal to 2AC square plus BC square. Okay. So we want AC square, AB square. We don't want AD. We don't want AD. So from the second equation, shall we write AC square minus BC square is AD square plus DC, we take it to other side. So when we take it to other side, we get AC square minus DC square is equal to AD square. We don't want AD. AD is common in both the equations, 1 and 2. So from the second equation, we find out what is AD and we substitute in first equation. We substitute this in first equation. So when you substitute this in first equation, AB square is equal to, what is AD? AC square minus CD square plus BD square. But look at the results. But look at the results, whether we are getting the results. What is given about BD? BD is given as? BD is given as 3CD, isn't it? BD is 3CD. So here BD square, if you replace it, we get AC square minus DC square. BD, what is BD? BD, we can replace it with 3CD, the whole square. So we get AC square minus DC square plus 9CD square. So from 9CD square, if we remove 1CD square, we get AB square is equal to, we get AB square is equal to, we get AB square is equal to AC square plus 8CD square. Whether we got the required results, compare it with the results. In the results, what we want, what do you have to prove? 2AB square is equal to 2AC plus BC. We don't want CD. We don't want CD. We should replace the CD. How will you replace? How will you do this? CD.
CD. For CD square.
Yes. Look at the figure.
BD.
BD is given as 3CD, isn't it? So in the figure, BC is equal to BD plus CD. Is or no? BC is BD plus CD. But what is given about BD? It is 3CD. So we can write this as BC is equal to 3CD plus CD. So we get BC is equal to 4CD. Is it correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So what will be CD? It is BC by 4. CD will be BC by 4. Listen, children. From the figure BC, this full length BC, we can split this as BD plus DC. BD plus DC. But what is BD? It is given 3CD. BD is given as 3CD. So instead of BD, you replace 3CD. So 3CD plus CD. 3CD plus CD means you will get 4CD. We get BC is equal to 4CD. Therefore, what will be CD? CD is BC by 4. BC by 4. So we substitute this in. So in the place of CD, you substitute BC by 4. So it is AC square plus 18. To CD, we can replace this with BC by 4, the whole square. So that is AC square plus 8 into BC square by 16. 8 and 16 if gets cancelled, so we get 2. So we get AB square is equal to AC square plus BC square by 2. AB square is equal to AC square plus BC square by 2. Take the common LCM 2. So we get 2 AB square is equal to 2AC square plus BC square. Hence, proved. Hence, we have proved this results.
Mom, can scroll up.
Here, we divide the triangles into two right triangles and we use the Pythagoras theorem. We use the Pythagoras theorem and the results for proving it. Afsana is present. Afsana? Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. You saw the up part of the board.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
See, the next class, do copy the questions and come. Okay, the questions which are left over, copy it and come. Try to solve it. Not only the questions, you try to solve that questions.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.